All right, we'll get to the starting lineups here momentarily. John Beltran back at Fort Morgan High School. Jessica Mendoza for the Fort Lupton Blue Devils, who's a sophomore, along with Georgie Heron, a senior. Johnny Heron, who's a junior. Yariska Delgado, a junior. And Edith Flores, who's a junior. Mustang starting lineup brought to you by Cargill Beef, committed to feeding the world in a responsible way by reducing environmental impact and improving products and processes. Learn about Cargill's story of commitment at Cargill.com. And the Mustangs go with sophomore Kelsey Shaver, along with Hallie Shaver, a fellow sophomore. Haley Lewis, the best player on this team statistically this season, who's only a sophomore. It's a very young Mustang squad. Lindsay Nestor. But check that, Abby Moosman. And now Lindsay Nestor in that particular order being introduced. Nestor, the lone senior in the starting lineup and one of two seniors on this team, along with Amy Anderson. And he's shown the head coach of the Mustangs and Noel Potter, the head coach of the Blue Devils, the opening tip tonight is brought to you by Ingmeyer Phillips Insurance. Looking to find insurance for your car, home, or even for you? Call Ingmeyer Phillips with two locations in Brush and Fort Morgan. They can help you with your home, car, health, or life insurance questions, or provide a quote. Ingmeyer Phillips Insurance. Haley Lewis will jump center with Edith Flores. Tip is controlled by the Mustangs. Here comes Shaver into the front court. Hallie Shaver gets a pick from Nestor on the outside right behind the three-point line. Inside to Nestor, scoops it up and in! Right off the bat for the Mustangs. Lindsay Nestor scores. And they've got the early 2-0 lead. Long pass on the left wing to Mendoza. Swings it near the top over there to Johnny Heron. Back out to Yariska Delgado. Right baseline penetration. Heron puts up a shot, air ball. The rebound to Delgado. She's stuck over there. Has got to kick it back out. Now the shot is missed from 15 feet away. And the rebound is into the hands of Haley Lewis. Lewis into the front court. As that shot was missed by Georgie Heron. Shaver on the outside right now to Nestor. Dribbling into the lane. Jump pass down low. Wide open. Banked up and in. Beautiful pass. As it's banked in by Abby Moosman. And the Mustangs lead 4-0, 1 minute into the game. The other way, it's Yariska Delgado on the outside right, picks up the dribble, nearly traveled, swings it cross court to Georgia Heron. Heron spinning towards the left baseline. That's Delgado with a basketball. Back near the top is Johnny Heron. Now Georgie stepping in, straight away to Mendoza. Mendoza fakes the three, Georgia Heron, long three is up and in, around, and no, it falls out, and the rebound is into the hands of Lindsay Nestor of Fort Morgan. The long outlet pass out of bounds intended for Lewis. That'll be the first turnover of the game committed by the Lady Mustangs, leading 4-0. 6:23 to go in the opening quarter. Georgie Heron, jump pass to the outside right to Mendoza behind the three-point line. Baseball pass inside. Jump shot is up and in off the glass by Johnny Heron, wide open from 5 feet away. Fort Lupton scores for the first time. It's 4-2, Fort Morgan. Shaver on the high left with the basketball. Back out to Abby Moosman. Moosman dribbles to her right. At the top, picks up the dribble. Looking, spinning, still looking. Got to get rid of it. Down low to the cutting Mustang off the bottom of the backboard. Out of bounds, and that was Kelsey Shaver, who was stuck underneath the basket. Fort Lupton basketball. Looks like we have an immediate substitution. Desiree Lewis into the game for Fort Lupton. And Carly Morales is in there as well. Into the front court is Delgado. Jump pass to the left baseline to Heron. Off the foot, out of bounds on that bounce pass inside for Edith Flores. And Fort Lupton commits the turnover. Mustang basketball up 4-2. 5:45 to go in the first. Here comes Shaver the other way for the Mustangs. Shaver met by Johnny Heron. Dribbling to her left. Bounce pass on the outside left Down low here, back out to Lewis. 10-footer around it, no good. Rebound and put back and a foul as the shot was missed by Abby Moosman, but she was hacked and she'll go to the line. And the foul was committed by Edith Flores. You got two Mustangs setting it up very nicely, and Kelsey and Hallie Shaver, the free throw is in the air, and that is good. Abby now with three in the game. Second free throw for Moosman is in the air, and that's off the right side of the rim. The long rebound to Desiree Lewis of Fort Lupton looking for the outlet. Mustangs apply the pressure. Bounce pass in the backcourt. Looked like it wasn't touched, but yet it's almost like she bounced it to herself. No whistle. Here comes Fort Lupton the other way. On the outside left for the basketball. Straight away to Heron. Near the right corner to Delgado. Delgado cross court at the top here for Morales. And then her bounce pass is intercepted. The other way. Here comes one Shaver to the other. Layup up and in. That is Hallie to Kelsey who scores. Fort Morgan now with a 7-2 lead. Second turnover by Fort Lupton. 4:53 to go in the first. On the outside left is Morales. And she traveled. Turnover number three. And it will be Fort Morgan basketball. And Fort Lupton's making a lot of substitutions here early. In and out are some of the same players who started the game, and we're just three-plus minutes in. Here's Hallie Shaver with the basketball. Bounce pass down low to Haley Lewis. Jump pass to Nestor. Steps in off the dribble. Five-footer around. No good. And there's a tie for the rebound. Same team. And on the line was the Mustang, Kelsey Shaver, so no official turnover. They were fighting for the ball, but they didn't communicate with each other. If not, it could have been an easy layup if one had just let go of the basketball. Here comes Fort Lupton the other way. 7-2. Fort Morgan on the outside right is Delgado. Delgado swings it at the top for Georgia Heron. Back to Delgado on the high right. Trying to move this motion offense with more proficiency. In the right corner, Georgie Heron, three in the air. Good. Actually, the right foot was on the line. Fort Lupton back on the board at 7-4. 4:06 to go. Long pass towards Lewis off her left hand out of bounds. Thrown by Kelsey Shaver. The Mustangs commit their second turnover. Caitlin Wells checks in for Fort Morgan. And here comes Georgie Heron into the front court on the outside left to Johnny. And now Fort Lupton calls a 30-second timeout. Rominger Jewelry and Gifts is the leader in Northeast Colorado for diamonds, jewelry, watches, and expert in-store jewelry repairs. For service, quality, and value, shop Rominger's in downtown Sterling. And Pete's Farmers Cooperative have been in business since 1915. That's 101 years. They're still the small-town company that cares about each of their individual customers. See them for all your propane, fuel, and farm needs. Pete's Farmers Cooperative. 3:59 to go, first quarter. Lady Mustangs lead 7-4 over the Blue Devils. Haley Lewis, Kelsey Shaver, Hallie Shaver, Caitlin Wells, and Lindsay Nestor for the Mustangs. Georgie Heron has the basketball, and now into the game is Laura Fluden out to Mendoza. Mendoza straight away, dribbling to her right. Looking down low for Fluden, but she's well covered on the outside left to Georgie Heron. Heron dribbles to her right, gets a pick, jump pass right side. There is a defensive foul against the Mustangs, apparently a push. Foul committed by Kelsey Shaver, that's her first. Both teams with one team foul more than midway through the opening quarter. There's the inbounds pass to Mendoza. Check that. That's Delgado in the left corner for Heron. Heron dribbling to her right. Jump pass. Cross court. Delgado steps in, lays it up, and she missed it. And the rebound into the hands of Hallie Shaver. Shaver into the front court. Bounce pass to Lewis on the left baseline. Lewis backs in, and then she is fouled as she tried to pass it off to Kelsey Shaver. Second team foul against Fort Lupton. And that's the first against Yariska Delgado. And to throw it in will be Kelsey Shaver. Check that, that's Hallie. Hallie jump pass to Kelsey. 15-footer banks it in straight away. Right at the free throw line. Kelsey Shaver now with four. The Mustangs lead 9-4. 3:10 to go in the opening quarter. Delgado on the outside left to Heron. Bounce pass straight away. As Johnny Heron back to Georgie. Long shot is up and in. Just inside the three-point line. For Georgie Heron, she's got four. Mustang lead down to three at 9-6. Hallie Shaver the other way, guarded tightly by Johnny Heron, looking. Bounce pass on the outside left to the other Shaver. Down low, wide open, dribbling, banking, and scoring off the feed from Kelsey Shaver's Hallie Shaver, her first points. Mustangs lead by five, 11-6, 2:37 to go. First quarter from Fort Morgan. The other way with the basketball is Delgado on the outside right. To Georgie Heron, right corner Delgado. She'll take the three, and that's a round and no good. And the ball is volleyballed into the hands of Johnny Heron, and then the ball was lost. Here comes Haley Lewis the other way with one to beat, all the way left-handed layup up and in. Haley Lewis scores for the first time, and the Mustangs lead 13-6. Jump pass on the outside left, right through the hands of Yariska Delgado, out of bounds. And Fort Lupton has committed the turnover. On the outside left, Caitlin Wells into the front court. Jump pass down low off the dribble. Moosman puts it up and misses. Gets the rebound. Banks and scores. She took a brief breather, but Moosman back into the game has got 5 points and two rebounds. Fort Morgan with their biggest lead. 15-6, a minute 38 to go, first quarter. Delgado, bounce pass to Fluden at the free throw line. Jump pass back out on the high right, penetrating Morales right baseline underneath, scoops it up and in. She drove right by two Mustangs and scored. The lead is down to 7, 15-8, a minute 21 to go. On the outside left is Moosman, jump pass down low. Lewis banks and scores and is fouled by Edith Flores, her second, and Haley Lewis to the line to shoot one. And Fort Morgan leads 17-8. Now the free throw by Haley Lewis, the sophomore, shoots and scores. Now what a solid player she is. Tough to stop. She has taken Fort Morgan to the next level, along with some of these other underclass women. 18-8. Got a minute 15 to go in the opening quarter. Fort Morgan with the lead. Morales into the front court. Picked up by Wells. Looking right side. Maintains the dribble outside left. With the basketball, it's Mariah Hilton in for Fort Lupton. Spinning along the baseline. Picks up the dribble. Back out to Delgado. Under a minute to go. Delgado being extremely patient. At the top. Dribbling to her right. Jump pass straight away to Morales. Morales to her right, in the right corner to Delgado, fakes a three, jump pass down low, a foul. And I believe that was in the entry pass, and Lindsey Nestor committed the foul for Fort Morgan. And to throw it in will be Hilton for Fort Lupton. Or she's going to be taken out of the game in favor of Georgie Heron. Heron to throw it in. To the left of the basket in the front court. Lobby gets straight away to Delgado, drops the ball, gets it back on the high right to Morales. Behind the three-point line, jump pass poked away, and it's intercepted by Moosman. That's turnover number six for Fort Lupton. Then they steal it. Morales takes it away, and then it's restolen there by Shaver all the way to Lewis. Lays it up and in with a right hand off the glass. Haley Lewis has seven in the opening quarter to go along with a rebound. Fort Morgan now leads by double digits, 20-8. Georgia Heron quickly, front court pass to Delgado, jump pass straight away to Mendoza. Dribbles nearly into a Mustang, kicks it back out. Delgado with 10 seconds to go. Delgado holding up the ball up high with six, in the lane is Edith Flores back out to Heron. Right corner Delgado, shot is up and short, and the ball is rebounded, put back in a miss. Didn't we have a foul at the buzzer? No, I don't think we did, as the rebound was grabbed by Jessica Mendoza. We have played 8 minutes in Fort Morgan. Lady Mustangs lead the Blue Devils 20-8. On Morgan County's B106 and B106.com. Let's head to the second quarter. I'm John Beltran in Fort Morgan. Lady Mustangs in the first of two lead Fort Lupton 20-8, going for the season sweep. In the right corner, Georgia Heron with a basketball straight away to Johnny Heron. Swings it left side to Delgado. Down low for Mendoza. Has the shot blocked, but she gets it back, and she puts it up off the back of the rim and misses. And then the Mustangs grab the rebound. Nice job by Abby Moosman, her third board. Here comes Fort Morgan the other way. Moosman on the high right. Swings it to Hallie Shaver at the top. Guarded closely by Johnny Heron. Dribbling to her left, and we've got a foul. Yeah, she was all over her. That'll be the first foul committed by Heron. Fourth on Fort Lupton. The Mustangs only have two with this 12-point advantage. Hallie Shaver to throw it in. The lob to Moosman. Also out there for the Mustangs is Maddie Griffith for the first time. Now here is Hallie Shaver. Shaver spinning at the top of the basketball. Looking, still looking. There's a pass to Riley Bauman into the game. And 30-second timeout. That was not a good offensive flow. Nice job by Andy Schoen to call that timeout. Did not look good whatsoever. That's brought to you by Ehrlich Toyota East. Whether you're in the market to purchase a new or pre-owned vehicle, Ehrlich Toyota East in Fort Morgan will fit you into the car truck of your choice. Serving all of Northeast Colorado, Ehrlich Toyota East. 7:13 to go, second quarter. And the Mustangs with a 20-8 lead on their home floor, trying to even their record at 9-9. Fort Lupton is still yet to pick up a league win this year at 0-8. Mustang basketball just beyond midcourt. Mustangs tonight in their home whites, and Fort Lupton in their royal blues. Pass into Moosman, back to Hallie Shaver. On the outside, left to Griffith. Takes a couple of dribbles back out towards Shaver. Baseball pass right side. Moosman right of the free throw line. Down low inside to Kelsey Shaver. Maddie Griffith shot, 10-footer, no good. Rebound, Shaver banks it in. Nice shot there by Kelsey Shaver. 6 points for her. Nearly outscoring Fort Lupton. It's 22-8. 6:45 to go, second quarter. On the outside, left, Delgado travels. Fort Lupton's eighth turnover. And the Mustangs come the other way. They won by 18 the first time around. They should have won even more handily tonight on their home floor. Hallie Shaver gets a pick from Bauman, dribbles to her left. Re-defensed over there by a couple of Blue Devils. Picks up the dribble down low for Kelsey. Shot is blocked, but she's fouled as she cut towards the basket. And the foul was on Yariska Delgado, her second. And to the stripe is Hallie Shaver to shoot two. And the first free throw's off the back of the rim by the sophomore. Second free throw upcoming. Fellow sophomore Haley Lewis is back into the game. This Fort Morgan squad's going to be really good in the next couple of years. They just need experience. A lot of sophomores on this team. Second free throw is good. That's 3 points now for Hallie Shaver. Mustangs with a 23-8 lead. On the outside, left is Morales. Jump pass inside, taken by Fluta and scoops it up right hand, no good. And Lindsay Nestor, check that. That's Haley Lewis with a rebound. Long pass to Moosman and lob down low for Shaver. Kicks it back out to the other Shaver. 15-footer banked, no. And the shot is missed off the rebound there by Haley Lewis. She'll go to the line as she's fouled. Haley Lewis asserting herself again. And is that Desiree Lewis committing her first foul? It is. Free throws here for Haley Lewis. And the first is perfect. 8 points and three rebounds for the sophomore. In fact, right now on the floor, you've got four sophomores and a junior for Fort Morgan. Second free throws in the air. Yes. Mustangs in the lead, 25-8. Solid opening quarter, carrying over to the second for Fort Morgan. Across the timeline is Georgia Heron at the top. Jump pass deflected by Shaver and chased down at midcourt by Heron. Back out to Morales. Morales dribbling to her right near the top of the three-point circle. Now retreats towards the timeline. Jump pass right at the free throw line. Now back out to Johnny Heron. to Morales. Cross court to Georgia here on. Two Blue Devils were right there, including Vanessa Castillo. Morales at the top. Swings it left corner for Johnny here on. Cross court to Georgie. 15-footer, yes. She's got six of the 10-4 Lupton points. Fort Morgan still up comfortably, 25-10. Hallie Shaver with a basketball, retreating towards the timeline. Maintains the dribble, gets a pick from Bauman. About to be called for 5 seconds. Got to get rid of the basketball, but now Fort Lupton retreats on defense to Moosman at the top. Bauman, 16-footer off to the left. Long rebound is grabbed by Haley Lewis, her fourth. Straight away with the basketball. 16-footer Moosman off the back of the rim. No, she grabs the rebound. She falls down. It lands in the hands, though, of Bauman. And the Mustangs reset very intelligently. Bauman on the high left. Holds the ball up high, dribbles to her left, feeds it back out to Moosman. Left of the free throw line, poked away, chased down near midcourt by Lewis. Back out to Hallie Shaver. Again, the Mustang reset. Jump pass to Lewis. Lewis cross-court pass taken by Moosman behind the three-point line on the outside left. Moosman picks up a dribble back near the timeline to Hallie Shaver. Again, they'll set up the offense again on the outside right to Bauman with a chest pass. Bauman jump pass down low. That's forced and a foul. And let's see if that's against Fort Lupton. And it is. Foul was committed by Vanessa Castillo. 17 foul, 1-1. Abby to shoot the free throw. She scored 5 points in the opening quarter. And this free throw is in the air and perfect. A smooth stroke for Abby Moosman. She's got six. Fort Morgan with a 16-point lead. At 26-10, Amy Anderson into the game for the Mustangs. Second free throw's upcoming. And that one is up, and that one is perfect. 27-10, Fort Morgan with 4:27 to go, second quarter. Heron in the backcourt. That is Georgia Heron. Bounce pass on the outside left to Delgado's got two fouls. Cross court to Johnny. On the outside left, Delgado steps in, can't take that shot. Holding the ball in her right hand. Jump pass down low is poked away by Lewis, but chased down by the Blue Devils and Edith Flores. Fort Lupton retains possession. Delgado dribbling towards the top of the three-point circle. Swings it right side to Heron. Long shot is up. Three-pointers missed. And the ball is volleyballed into the hands of Hallie Shaver's second rebound. Shaver across the timeline. Picked up by Delgado. Dribbles by Delgado on the left baseline. All the way off the glass. No good. Rebound. And the putback is missed by Lewis. And then we got a whistle and a foul. I believe that's against Fort Morgan. And a push-off there by Hallie Shaver. Hallie commits her first. Once again, Haley Lewis putting together a monster game. 9 points and 5 rebounds, and we've only played about 12-plus minutes of basketball. Mustangs will pressure up 17. Delgado across the timeline, dribbling right to the free throw line, stripped and fouled. That'll be the fourth team foul against Fort Morgan. Again, Hallie Shaver with a foul, her second. Three quarters court. Heron to throw it in to Delgado. Back to Georgia Heron. Dribbles to her left, right of the free throw line, in the lane. Bounce pass to Johnny Heron. She fell down and she traveled with a basketball. Fort Morgan has not committed a miscue here in this second quarter. Fort Lupton with 9 turnovers and the Mustangs with 3. And the difference is also in the scoreboard, where Fort Morgan leads 27-10, 3.5 to go before the break. Hallie Shaver at the top of the three-point circle. Bounce pass on the outside right. Taken by Lindsay Nestor near the right corner for Kelsey Shaver. Down low to the cutting Lewis Banks and scores to the right of the basket. Lewis now has 11 points in the opening half, outscoring Fort Lupton. Long pass towards Mendoza. That one is tipped away, intercepted. Here comes Lewis the other way. Lewis with one. David squeezes in. 5-footer. Good. Straight away. Haley Lewis. Man, she can do it all. 13 in the game. Off Fort Lupton's 10 turnover. 31-10 Fort Morgan. 2:52 to go. Second quarter. Georgia Heron with the basketball. Spinning on the outside left. Straight away to Delgado. Delgado swings it left side to Johnny Heron. Double team. Jump pass in the lane to Desiree. Back out to Delgado. Straight away Heron. Three in the air. Is off to the right. And the rebound on one hop into the hands of Lindsay Nestor. That's her second board. Long pass to Hallie Shaver. Inside Kelsey Shaver. Banks and scores to the right of the hoop for Kelsey Shaver. She's got eight. Excellent feed by Hallie. It's 33-10. 2:18 to go before the break. Pressure being applied in the backcourt. Now the Mustangs retreat with this big lead. Smart thing to do there. Straight away Delgado swings it left side to Heron. Looking down low, dribbles to her right. Back out to Delgado, holding the ball on her right hip. We have an even 2 minutes to go before halftime. Right side bounce pass to Heron. Bounce pass inside, triple teamed is Desiree, and then just stripped out of her hand by Haley Lewis. Lewis picks up the dribble, jump pass to Kelsey Shaver. Back out to Haley Shaver. Check that. That's Hallie Shaver, I should say. I knew I was going to say that wrong once. On the outside, left to Nestor, behind the three-point line, left of the lane. Left corner, Kelsey Shaver, three, is off the back of the rim. And the ball is fought for. It's out of bounds, and I believe it's off Fort Morgan. It is. With a minute 35 to go in the second. And to trigger it in will be Yariska Delgado. Gianna Tijerina is into the game now for Fort Lupton. And Delgado is met at the top by Hallie Shaver. Mustangs in a 2-3 defensively. Over to Tijerina straight away to Heron. Not at Tijerina. Little 10-footer is up and good with the left hand. Well, the way she shot that, she should have been in the starting lineup. 33-12 Mustangs. A minute 11 remaining. Outside right, Caitlin Wells back into the game. Back to Hallie Shaver. Shaver retreats towards the timeline. Bounce pass outside left to Nestor. Nestor into the lane all the way off the glass and in with a left hand. Lindsay Nestor now with four. And the Mustangs are back up by 23. 35-12. 53 seconds to go before the break. Delgado across the timeline for Fort Lupton. Swings it right side to Heron. As Johnny Heron straight away for Tijerina. On the left baseline to Delgado. Mustangs pick her up. Now she retreats beyond the three-point line, straight away to Heron. Back to Delgado, 35 seconds to go. Looking down low, Edith Flores covered. Right baseline is Johnny Heron, straight away to Delgado. Swings it outside left to Hedina. She's double-teamed, straight away again to Delgado. Back on the high right to Heron, 21 seconds to go. Here's Delgado on the high right with 17. Swings it cross-court to Hedina, looking inside. Back at the top of the three-point circle to Delgado. Right baseline to Heron. We've got 9 seconds remaining. Great defense by Fort Morgan. On the outside left to Delgado with five. Puts up a long shot, and it's nothing but glass. And the rebound to Haley Lewis, and she's fouled in the backcourt with 1.5 seconds to go. And that will essentially mean a 1-1. Foul was committed by Tijerina. And Lewis to shoot the first of hopefully two. She's outscored Fort Lupton in the quarter, but she missed the free throw. Rebound and putback is missed there by Lindsay Nestor. And that is the end of the opening half, dominated by the Fort Morgan Lady Mustangs. As they lead at the break, 35-12. Time for a 3-minute break. On Morgan County's B106 and B106.com. Let's hit the third quarter momentarily in Fort Morgan. Lady Mustangs, a very solid first half, are in the lead 35-12. Yeah, they had a one-sided loss in non-conference play to Sterling 70-15 right here. But I'd like to see this same Fort Morgan team in a year or two against that Sterling team. It would close the gap significantly, considering that Sterling team is, they do have some good young players, but they've got some solid experienced players as well. And Fort Morgan doesn't have a ton of experience, but they do have a lot of young talent. Lady Blue Devils have emerged from the locker room trying to figure out how to score on a more consistent basis in the second half. Yeah, that first half was tough to say the least. Let's see how they break the huddle. It'll be Georgie Heron, Johnny Heron, Yariska Delgado, Jessica Mendoza, and Edith Flores. It'll be Mustang basketball to begin the third with Hallie Shaver, Kelsey Shaver, Abby Moosman, the inbounds passer, Lindsay Nestor, and Haley Lewis. Here's the inbounds to Hallie Shaver on the outside left to Moosman. Cross-court pass to Kelsey, 10-footer off the back of the rim. Mendoza grabs the rebound for Fort Lupton, her third. There's the outlet to Delgado. Delgado at the top. Swings it right corner to Georgie Heron. Dribbles to her left. Picks up the dribble. Hands it off to Delgado. Looking down low, but Haley Lewis has the lane cut off beautifully. Delgado on the high left to Georgie Heron. Bounce pass left to the free throw line for Flores, and looks like she's tied up. She is. Possession arrow stays with Fort Lupton. And to throw it in will be Georgie Heron. Georgie led Fort Lupton with 6 points in the opening half. There's the lob to Delgado, right baseline, all the way, scoops it up, and she misses on the layup. And Mendoza had the rebound. Now it's loose on the floor. Now it's volleyball all over the place. And there's going to be another tie-up between Mendoza and Lindsay Nestor. Possession arrow, Fort Morgan. And to throw it in will be Kelsey Shaver. Yeah, the second half moves along. We could have an early start to the boys' game. Scheduled to go at 7 o'clock. Here is Lewis to Shaver. Back to Shaver. Here's Kelsey. Left baseline. 15-footer. Good. Kelsey Shaver now with 10. The Mustangs a minute into the third. Lead by 25. 37-12. Heron bounce pass. Outside left to Delgado. Left baseline. Double team. Back out towards Flores. Flores spinning. Looking. Bounce pass to Mendoza. Turn. Shoots. Scores. Little hook shot there by Mendoza. Her first points, 37-14. Straight away, Hallie Shaver. Baseball pass to Moosman. Lobs it cross court to Shaver. Dribbles left of the lane towards the baseline. Down low to Kelsey. Back out to Moosman. Head fake. Has a shot blocked. Gets it back. Down low to Nestor Banks, and she misses. And then Hallie Shaver lost the basketball. Loose in the floor. And we have another tie up the third of the third quarter. Possession arrow is pointing in Fort Lupton's direction. And a trigger it in will be Delgado. The Mustangs not pressing anymore. They stopped at it at about the second quarter. And across the timeline, here comes Fort Lupton. And then the Heron pass went through everybody out of bounds. Fort Lupton with their 12th turnover. And the other way, here comes Hallie Shaver. Shaver dribbling towards the top on the outside right with the basketball is Moosman. Down low inside to Lewis, and she's fouled as she misses. And the foul was committed by, let's see, they signaled that that was, yeah, Vanessa Castillo shut quickly into the game. And the free throw by Lewis is in. Second free throw upcoming. That one is up, and that one's off the back of the rim. It goes in. Took that high bounce. Outside left is Morales with a basketball. Spinning, looking. Trapped over there. Swings it left corner to Castillo. Castillo dribbling to her right. At the top to Delgado. Delgado, long three, is off the back of the rim. And who else? Haley Lewis grabs the rebound, her seventh. Lewis into the front court, left-handed dribble, jump pass to Nestor. Nestor lost it, gets it back on the left baseline. Now loose in the floor, she picks it up. Swings it back out to Hallie Shaver. Shaver with the basketball. Left baseline to Nestor, dribbling left baseline all the way. Underneath, reverse layup off the bottom of the backboard. And it's grabbed by Edith Flores of Fort Lupton. That's her first rebound. The other way is Georgia Heron. Straight away, left corner Delgado. She will not take the three. She'll dribble to her right. And reset the offense for Fort Lupton. Dribbling left baseline all the way. Morales bounce pass to Flores. Nearly trapped left of the lane. Is trapped. Gets it back out to Morales. Swings it back out at the top for Heron. Back to Morales, now to Delgado for Lupton running this offense, but a little bit deliberate. Here's Heron, runner, left baseline, short from 10. And the rebound to Abby Moosman of Fort Morgan. That's her fifth. The Mustangs come the other way. Long shot is up and missed from 15 feet away by Nestor. And the ball is chased down. And was it thrown away? It was thrown off a Mustang, out of bounds off the rebound by Yariska Delgado. And Fort Morgan will have the basketball. 4.5 to go in the third. And the Mustangs lead by 25. Here's Delgado with the basketball. Near the top is Delgado. In the right corner, here's Morales with the basketball. Jump pass on the outside left to Heron, straight away to Delgado. Delgado now takes the shot from 15, and that is no good. Tipped into the hands of Morales. They reset the three by Heron, in and out. And there's a loose ball, now a tie-up. And that stays. It'll stay with Fort Lupton. And to throw it in is going to be Georgia Heron. Left baseline shot is missed by Morales, and the rebound is controlled by Amy Anderson. Here come the Mustangs the other way. Maddie Griffith into the game. Here for Fort Morgan. Swings it right side as the Mustangs now have some of the junior varsity players off the bench. Bauman at the free throw line. Now the shot by Caitlin Wells is short from 15. And the rebound into the hands of Georgie Heron. Here's Fort Lupton the other way. Heron banks and misses, but she's fouled. And she's fouled in the lane over there on the penetration to the basket by Maddie Griffith. So we have the first free throws attempted here by Fort Lupton. 3.5 to go in the third. This is in the entire game. And the Heron free throws back rimmed. They still have just 2 points in the quarter. Second free throw upcoming. Live in your world. Earn in ours at Northeastern. Go to njc.edu. Second free throw round and good. 39 to 15. And let's see. Bauman will throw it into Maddie Griffith. Griffith across the timeline on the outside right, and then she turned the ball over. The turnover for Fort Morgan is their fourth of the game and their first since the opening quarter. And Morales to trigger it in. Morales gets it into Delgado. Delgado across the timeline. Swings it near the left corner to Morales. Morales spinning near the top. Maintaining the dribble now is Delgado. At the top for Morales. Swings it left baseline here to Mariah Hilton. Lost the basketball. Loose in the floor. Poked out of bounds. It stays with the Blue Devils. Approaching the three-minute mark of the third quarter, Fort Morgan leads 39-15. Morales to throw it in. Lobs it on the outside, left to Delgado. Left baseline, Hilton fakes the three, steps in, dribbles five-footer short, and the ball is loose. It's off the hand of Bauman out of bounds. Yeah, I think that Fort Morgan player, let's see, boy, I don't know who that is. And the shot is missed left baseline. The rebound taken by Maddie Griffith. Maddie Griffith with her first board across the timeline towards the top. 2:50 to go, third quarter. Mustangs lead by 24. Caitlin Wells, 15-footer in and out. And the ball is tipped out of bounds, but I think Riley Bauman went over the back and commits Fort Morgan's second team foul. And for Bauman, that'll be her first personal. Nope, still on the roster. Okay, Michaela Forsyth into the game for Fort Morgan. I was looking at the wrong section there. Mustangs have a nice deep roster. They can rotate virtually every player in this game. And here come the Blue Devils the other way on. Three team fouls committed in this second half. On the outside left is Hilton. Hilton looking, bounce pass, left corner, 15-footer Heron, yes. Georgia Heron now has 9 in the game, 39-17. The Mustangs have scored just 4 points in a quarter. Forsyth straight away to Griffith. Bounce pass, free throw line. Bauman back to Forsyth. Dribbles. 12-footer is an air ball. And it's out of bounds off of Fort Morgan. Yeah, the Mustangs are being outscored in the quarter 5-4, but you've got your starters out, so you get some experience here. At the top with the basketball is Castillo. She's fouled. Third team foul on the Mustangs as she turned. Caitlin Wells commits her first. Hilton to throw it in, and now the Mustangs with a lot of substitutions, and the starters are back in. Because it's been a rough third quarter, they'll play here for the final 2:15 of the quarter. That means Yariska Delgado and Johnny Heron check in for Fort Lupton, along with Desiree Lewis. Georgie Heron to throw it in. Bounce pass right corner to Tijerana. Over to Delgado. Tijerana in the right corner. Double team. The Mustangs in that 2-3. Bounce pass near the top. Nearly poked away. Retained by Delgado. Cross court pass to Heron. Can't take that three. Dribbles to her left. Spinning on Kelsey Shaver at the top. Now for Delgado. Left corner. Heron. Shot is up and short. And the rebound into the hands of Hallie Shaver. That's her third board. Long pass to Kelsey. Down low for Lewis. Banks and scores. To the left of the basket is Haley Lewis. She's got 17. And the Mustangs lead 41-17, a minute 41 to go, third quarter. Delgado straight away in the right corner for Georgia Heron behind the three-point line. Dribbles to her left. At the free throw line, in the lane, jump pass, left baseline. There's a foul on Lewis. That'll be the 14th foul. And her second, or is that her first? Let's see. I believe it's her first. Well, the Mustangs up by 24. That is her first. And to trigger it in is Heron. There's Mariah Hilton back into the game. Looking, still looking. Lobs it towards the top to Delgado. Swings it cross court to Heron. Long shot is up and in. Just outside the three-point line. That's a triple. Heron's got 6 points in a quarter, 12 in the game. She's got as many points in the quarter as Fort Morgan does, but the Mustangs lead by 21 with a minute 13 to go. Pass to Lewis. She's fouled as she misses. Excellent entry pass. And there were two Blue Devils who made contact there, but the one the foul is called on is Laura Flutzen. So to the line will be Haley Lewis, and the free throw is good. She now has 18 in the game. And Fort Morgan leads by 22. Second free throw upcoming. She bends, she shoots, she scores. Now the Mustangs have scored 8 points in a quarter. A minute seven remaining on the outside right. Delgado with a basketball jump pass poked away by Kelsey Shaver. Intercepted by Kelsey. Turnover number 13 for Fort Lupton. Hallie Shaver down low. The shot is up and in. It's banked in. On the right baseline by Abby Moosman, who was wide open from about 6 feet away. She's got 9 in the game. Fort Morgan leads by 25, 45-20. Hilton on the high left, bounce pass, left corner. And the shot is blocked beautifully by Moosman on the three-pointer from Heron over to Lewis. Now to Shaver, banks it in. Beautiful. Boy, that's a beautiful full-court game by Fort Morgan as Kelsey Shaver scores. She's got 12. 29 seconds to go. There is a steal from Hallie Shaver. Nobody to beat. She'll lay it up and in with a left hand. Hallie Shaver now with 5. Mustangs have put together a nice run here, an 8-0 run. With 19.6 seconds to go in the third. Let's keep it right here, leading by 29. 49-20. Well, that was beautiful by Fort Morgan using that defense to create offense. And it certainly worked there. Now let's see what head coach Andy Schoen does. At the end of three, he takes out the starters. Fort Lupton was making a very small comeback. I mean, they wouldn't have threatened to win this game. But you don't want your starters, even in a big game, margin-wise, to play just half a game. So he had him out for a decent portion of the third, brought him back in. And the result has been very good. 11 here tonight in Fort Morgan. Of course, the Morgan County Triple Duel on 1010 and KSRYard.com is going on in Brush. So that's certainly drawing a very, very heavy crowd. Fort Lupton basketball, 19.6 to go here. With a 29-point lead for the Mustangs. And to trigger it in, it'll be to Yariska Delgado. Delgado at the top, picked up by Shaver. Lobs it on the outside left to Hilton. Hilton penetrating left baseline, cut off by Moosman. Now re-penetrates. Bounce pass inside, knocked away by Nestor. Loose in the floor, still loose. And then it's picked up by Hilton, trapped underneath, double teamed. And then we get a whistle and a foul. The Mustangs committing the foul. And that is on Moosman. That's the team's fifth. And to throw it in will be Hilton. Hilton to trigger it in. In the left corner to Castillo. That's the end of the quarter. Didn't take a shot. We have played three with a score. Lady Mustangs of Fort Morgan 49, Fort Lupton 20. How about a 1 minute break on Morgan County's B106 and B106.com? Lady Mustangs have the basketball. I'm John Beltran back in Fort Morgan. They're 8 minutes away from their ninth win of the season, 49-20. Lindsey Nestor to throw it in midcourt. Lobs it into the backcourt to Hallie Shaver out there with Kelsey Shaver, Haley Lewis, and Abby Moosman. Mariah Hilton, Georgia Heron, Johnny Heron, Vanessa Castillo, Yariska Delgado for Fort Lupton. Moosman, cross-court pass to Hallie Shaver. In the right corner with the basketball down low. Now inside is Lewis, and had the ball stripped away beautifully. Fort Morgan with only their fifth turnover committed. Delgado on the outside right with the basketball. Hands it off back to Heron. Bounce pass towards Hilton as the Mustangs fight for the basketball. And let's see, I think we had another. Nope, just the ball went out of bounds as Shaver poked it away. And to throw it in will be Heron. Back to Delgado, now to Heron. Takes the long three, and that's way off. And Haley Lewis grabs her eighth rebound. There's the outlet to Moosman. Moosman with two to beat. He's going to pull up, now back it up at the free throw line, and now retreating is Hallie Shaver outside right to Kelsey. Back to Hallie. 7:05 to go in the game. On the outside left to Moosman. Down low to Kelsey Shaver. Wide open. She banks it in. Kelsey now with 14. And it's now a 51-20 game. 6:52 to go. Here's Delgado with a basketball between her legs. Jump pass towards the corner. Poked away by Lewis. Chased down near midcourt by Delgado. Guarded by the two Shavers. Stripped by Hallie. Now it's loose in the backcourt. No over and back because it was touched by a Mustang. Here's Delgado on the right side to Johnny Heron. With a basketball, now it's Delgado. And now we got a whistle and a foul. That'll be Fort Morgan's sixth foul. They don't want to get sloppy defensively. Abby Moosman, I believe, has committed her second. Nope, correction, Lindsey Nestor. For Lupton basketball, right corner, Johnny Heron. Lobs it down low for Flores. She scoops and misses, but fouled by Lewis. Lewis thought she didn't foul her, but she did throw in her left hip. It's a good call. Haley with her second. And now to the line is Edith Flores. Fort Morgan outscored Fort Lupton 14-8 in the third. And the free throw's up and in. Second free throw upcoming. That one is off the back of the rim. And the rebound to Nestor. Inside to Lewis, banks and scores off the pass from Shaver on the right baseline. Haley Lewis again, she's got 21. And it's a clinic, 53-21, under 6 minutes to go in the game. Georgia Heron on the outside right to Delgado, holding the ball up high. Swings it right corner for Heron, dribbles to her left against Lindsey Nestor. Bounce pass on the outside right to Delgado, holds the ball on her right hip. By the way, Fort Morgan with 17 fouls, Fort Lupton with two. Baseball pass thrown out of bounds by Delgado. Turnover number 15 for the Blue Devils. Now, I would imagine these Fort Morgan starters don't have too much time left in the game with 5:43 to go. You still have all five out there. And here is Laura Fludine into the game for Fort Lupton. This will be an easy season sweep for the Mustangs. Ali Shaver, left-handed dribble, bounce pass to Moosman. Cross-court pass to Nestor. 15-foot rainbows and air ball picked up by Kelsey Shaver. She scores underneath the basket. Very attentive. Kelsey now has 16. The other way, here's Heron back out to Delgado. Bounce pass in the right corner for Johnny Heron. 55-21 Fort Morgan, 34-point lead with 5:12 to go in the game. Delgado, left-handed dribble. Well behind the three-point line. Maintains the dribble. Swings it right side to Johnny Heron. Now to Georgie Heron. Back to Delgado. Double team. Jump pass to Fludine. And then had the ball stripped away. It's loose in the floor. And we're going to have a tie-up here. And possession arrow is pointing to the Mustangs. And to throw it in. It's going to be Amy Anderson, Maddie Griffith in there, Michaela Forsyth, Caitlin Wells. Also for Fort Morgan, Kelsey Callis. And she's only a freshman. Here's Wells, baseball pass intended for Forsyth, out of bounds. And we're going to have more turnovers now because of the youth of these players on the court. That's going to happen. With 4:39 to go. And there's a good shot that we start the boys' game early. It's only 6:34, and we have just over 4.5 minutes to go in this game. Delgado on the high left, swings at left corner Heron. Runners up and good on the left baseline. That's a long runner there by Georgie Heron. She's had a nice game. She's got 14 points. 55-23 Fort Morgan. Bounce pass for Griffith, nearly botted up by Heron, then Heron commits the foul. Team's third, Johnny with her second. And for Lupton making substitutions at this point as well. First National Bank in Fleming. Bank your financial needs with the Logan County Home Dome Bank since 1917. First National Bank in Fleming, member FDIC. Here's Wells, 10-footer right baseline off the back of the rim. Jessica Mendoza has the rebound for Fort Lupton. Here's Yariska Delgado straight away against Wells. Bounce pass right corner here, and 15-footer good. And she's had an excellent game. Now with 16. 16 of Fort Lupton's 25 points. Maddie Griffith to Forsyth, penetrating right baseline, puts up a runner. Nothing but air. Mendoza with another rebounder, fifth for the Blue Devils. Under 3.5 to go. Here on the other way, back out to Delgado, who has not scored tonight. Now to Edith Flores. She's fouled. 1-1 situation. Amy Anderson committed the foul. That's her first. And Flores was just at the line. Delgado is out, and Carla Morales is in. And here we go with the front end of the 1-1, and that one is up, and that's bricked off the back of the rim. And the ball is loose. It's picked up by Fort Lupton and Johnny Heron. They'll reset over to Georgie, spinning right of the lane. Bounce pass inside. The ball's loose on the floor. Picked up now to Georgie. Misses the 15-footer. And now that one is controlled by Caitlin Wells of Fort Morgan. Wells to Griffith. 3 minutes to go. Griffith at the top. Nearly stripped. Was stripped. Picks it up. Back out to Forsyth. Takes a dribble. Right baseline. Wells puts up an air ball from about 8 feet away. Mendoza has it for Fort Lupton. Long pass towards Johnny Heron out of bounds. And the Blue Devils commit their 16th turnover. 2:47 to go. This is a 30-point game. At 55-25. Maddie Griffith for the Mustangs. Across the timeline, bounce pass on the outside right to Forsyth. Dribbling to her right, right corner. Wells steps in, 15-footer, misses, but she's fouled. Vanessa Castillo with her third. Caitlin Wells with a chance to score for the Mustangs. And she is only a sophomore. Free throw is up and off the back of the rim. Make Stubbs Gas and Oil your next stop heading out of town. During your visit, you can gas up your vehicle, sit down to lunch, get snacks, and your hunting and fishing licenses. No good second free throw. Ball is out of bounds. Off the miss off of Amy Anderson. That's Stubbs Gas and Oil. Find everything you need at low prices. It's in Wiggins. Heron to Mendoza at the free throw line. Swings it right corner. Castillo down low for Heron. And then she's going to be fouled. Not a tie-up, but a foul. It'll be the 19th foul. Mustangs playing aggressive defensively. Maddie Griffith with her second. I'll check that the board's got that as her first. And now Georgie Heron has had a huge game for Fort Lupton. 16 points tonight, and this free throw is in. If she had any help out there, this could be a more competitive team, but she is the offense. Delgado back in. Delgado handles the ball pretty well, but has been unable to score. Second free throw is up, and that's good. 18 for Georgia Heron, 55-27. And here come the Mustangs the other way. On the outside right, Wells with the basketball at the top for Griffith. Swings it left side. Amy Anderson, 15-footer. Banks and no good. And Mendoza with a rebound. Mendoza with her seventh. There's the outlet to Delgado. 2:05 to go in the game. On the outside right with the basketball. Three in the air. Heron is in and out. And the ball is rebounded in one hop by Maddie Griffith. Griffith into the front court. All the way scoops it up wildly and misses. And Vanessa Castillo grabs the rebound. Then she's hacked to the back court. Double bonus situation. And two free throws coming up here for Vanessa Castillo. Well, the Mustangs up 55-27. Awaiting the first free throw. It's up and in. Accidents and illness can strike at any time, day and night, when they do, every second counts. As a Level 3 Trauma Center, Colorado Plains Medical Center can handle any type of emergency. Colorado Plains Medical Center, second free throw back rim. Mendoza grabs the rebound. Baseline throws up a prayer and misses, but she's fouled. All right, now this game's being extended a little bit too long because of all the fouls. And that one. See Kelsey Callis, and the free throw is in by Mendoza. Second free throw in and out. Riley Bauman grabs the rebound, then she's fouled. That'll be the 15th foul. And Mendoza, or was that Delgado instead with her third? And here comes Fort Morgan the other way. It's a 26-point game. Hopefully we get through this without too many more fouls. Callis, 15-footer. Good straight away for the freshman. Mustangs lead by 28, 57, 29. A minute 28 to go. Castillo on the high left. Jump pass cross court to Heron. Dribbles to her left straight away to Castillo. Castillo free throw line for Mendoza. Dribbles into traffic. And then she's tied up. That's not a foul. Yeah, that is a tie-up. Possession arrow, Fort Lupton, 78 seconds to go. And let's see, to throw it in, it's going to be here on bounce pass in the right corner to Delgado, and she drills a three, her first points of the game. Fort Lupton's had a big fourth quarter, only down 25. They were down by much more. Bauman, 10-foot rainbow, yes. That is Riley Bauman with her first points. 59-32, under a minute to go. Castillo dribbles right of the lane, straight away to Heron. Back to Castillo on the high right. She puts up a three, air ball. Amy Anderson has it for the Mustangs. Watch out from behind. Jump pass to Griffith. Griffith, lob pass inside, poked away. Taken by Bauman. Inside to Anderson. She's fouled as she misses. Castillo got her with a body. Amy Anderson to the stripe to shoot a deuce. With 42 seconds to go, a 27-point game. And here we go with the two free throws. Anderson. Benz shoots and misses off to the right. Second free throw upcoming for the senior. Mustangs trying to hit the 60-point mark. They haven't done that too many times. Second free throw is up, and that's good. Amy Anderson becomes the 10th player into the scoring column, I believe, for Fort Morgan. Left corner shot is up and off the back of the rim, missed by Mortales. Resetting as Fort Lupton. Delgado grabs the rebound. Inside to Mendoza. Mendoza in the lane. Dribbles, trapped over there, and then she's fouled. Holy mahungus. It's about 12 team fouls, 12 or 13 on Fort Morgan in this half. That one on Callis, the freshman. Two free throws for Mendoza. 18 seconds to go. Fort Morgan leads by 28. First free throw is up and in. Nothing but string. Quite a few points in this quarter. Both teams in double digits, which we haven't seen in any quarter. But this one, second free throw. Off to the right. Rebound to Bauman. Let's see if Fort Morgan dribbles out the clock. Wells just across the timeline. That should have been an over and back, but no call. Now to Wells with 8 seconds to go. Dribbling to her right. Bounce pass right baseline. Loose in the floor. We'll have a tie-up. And Fort Morgan retains possession of the basketball. Now just throw it in, and that's it. With 2.6 seconds to go. Wells to looking, still looking. Lobs it to Anderson. Dribbles to her left. She'll dribble out the clock. And the Fort Morgan Lady Mustangs have won tonight. And they do it rather handily. By a score of 60-33. Very convincing effort here tonight in Fort Morgan against a Fort Lupton team that still is looking for their first league win of this season. All right, we're going to take a break. And we will make it about a good 3-minute break. Lady Mustangs win 60-33 over the Fort Lupton Blue Devils. We'll come back with a recap on Morgan County's B106 and B106.com. Lady Mustangs win tonight 60-33 in very impressive fashion. Over the Fort Lupton Blue Devils, I'm John Beltran. Welcome to the Mustang post-game show, which is brought to you by Morgan Community College. Hey, find out why Morgan Community College is the best choice for your higher education. Visit MCC online at morgancc.edu. Or stop by the campus for a personal advising session. MCC, there to help you imagine your possibilities, believe in yourself, and achieve your goals. Morgan Community College. Mustangs led 20-8 after one quarter. And then a very nice second quarter, 15-4 run by Fort Morgan. 14-8 in the third, and they were outscored 13-11 in the fourth. For the visiting Blue Devils, they got 18 points from Georgie Heron, and she was the main scorer. In fact, for Fort Lupton, there were 7 other players in the scoring column, and she outscored the other 7 combined. 3 points by Yariska Delgado, 4 by Jessica Mendoza, 2 apiece from Johnny Heron, Carla Morales and Gianna Tijerina, 1 free throw for Vanessa Castillo and 1 for Edith Flores. The Mustangs get a monster game there from Haley Lewis, 21 points and 9 rebounds, make it 8 rebounds, 16 points for Kelsey Shaver, and then Abby Moosman had 9 in the game, 5 from Hallie Shaver, 4 points for Lindsay Nestor, and then 2 from Riley Bauman and Kelsey Callis. A single free throw for Amy Anderson. 16 turnovers for Fort Lupton, 6 for Fort Morgan. That's a very nice low total. 29 rebounds for the Mustangs, 18 for Fort Lupton, 8 of those from Jessica Mendoza. At the line, Fort Lupton barely above 50%. They were 7 of 13. Fort Morgan was 12 out of 18 in the game, 67%. With a victory, Lady Mustangs are now 8-1 in the Colorado 7 League, 9-9 overall. Fort Lupton is 0-9 in league play, 2-15 on the season. In fact, while we have a chance, we still have some time here in between games. We'll take a brief look at the Colorado 7 League standings. Because Fort Morgan's in this thing with a very young squad. They are certainly in it. And we'll pull up the numbers here momentarily. But this Fort Morgan team that obviously now in future seasons wants to establish itself not only inside the conference more consistently, which they have this year, but outside of the conference. That's one thing that they have struggled with a 1-8 league record here in 2015-2016. Boys game will start here momentarily. Yeah, still waiting to pull up these standings in the Colorado 7 League, where both Fort Morgan teams are certainly competing for supremacy. And, well, in the meantime, Willow Coffee Tea and Smoothies and G Suites Bakery. Try a new breakfast bowl or delicious breakfast burrito with your Willow Coffee or Tea. Open 6 days a week at 921 Edison Street. And that is In Brush, Willow Coffee Tea and Smoothies and G Suites Bakery. Coming into tonight, we know that Alameda and Fort Lupton were at the bottom. Englewood was 3-5 in league play, 7-9 overall. Skyview at 4-5 and 9-9. Weld Central, which handed Fort Morgan their only league loss, was 5-4 and 8-9. Elizabeth 7-2 in league play, 11-6 overall. Lady Mustangs will go to Alameda Tuesday, to Elizabeth on Friday. We'll have all those games on B106 and B106.com. And now Fort Morgan, 8-1 after the victory. Vista Peak has won 8 consecutive games, and they are hosting Englewood tonight. You would anticipate that that's going to be a victory, the 14th of the season for Vista Peak, and then the league title would be decided on February the 19th, 2 weeks from tonight, when the Mustangs go to Aurora to face that Vista Peak team, unless Elizabeth can somehow climb back into it. Final score once again tonight, the Lady Mustangs defeat the Fort Lupton Blue Devils 60-33. Let's take an extended break, and then we'll come back as we approach the start of tonight's boys game right here on Morgan County's B106 and B106.com.